Allez, bonjour à tous, bonjour, j'espère que vous allez bien. So this lesson will be in English because we're having, the level is for the beginners, so this is the reason why it will be in English and obviously in French for the exercises. Armit Waralsh offered me a coffee. Merci beaucoup, Armit, the usual. Merci Armit. Stardust est avec nous. Darktainer est là. Sundar est là. Coucou. Gloria est avec nous aussi. Strange 73 est là aussi. Romand est avec nous. Evelyne, coucou. Luciana, deux jours. Alors Luciana, bonjour. Comment dire? Il y a deux jours pour la fête ou deux jours manquent pour la fête ou quelle est la meilleure façon? Dans deux jours, c'est la fête. Victoria Possé est là, Hilary est avec nous, Annabelle est là aussi, même si c'est la nuit, elle est courageuse Annabelle, Vouslat est là, Renato, coucou, Victoria Jacques, bonjour, Bébé Moette est là aussi de Californie, coucou, Louisa est avec nous, Denora est là, Nada est là aussi, Julia, coucou, qu'est-ce qu'il y a aussi, Edgley est avec nous, Cherylyn, bien sûr, aussi la nuit, quelqu'un qui est courageux. Nada, vous avez une question? Well, it will be in English, this one, and usually we try to make some exercises, so I'm not really sure if I will have the time to answer your question. Mais bon, on commence. Don't forget to click on the like button, because of course the objective, the goal is to do it. Trois jours to have 100 likes for this lesson. Alors, Ice Cubes is joining us. Coucou, avec des personnages intéressants. Eh oui, let's start with the bad news. The bad news of the day. It's really sad. It is sad. The French band, I don't know if you knew this band, but still, it was quite... I really love this band. So, Daft Punk is a French band. They usually don't do anything in French, it's in English. But still, le groupe français Daft Punk se sépare. Et oui, et c'est terrible, et je suis très, 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 très triste. C'est dommage. Voilà, ça fait longtemps qu'ils étaient ensemble, so they've been together for quite a while. They've been doing some incredible things. I really loved them, and I still do. But that this is the bad and the sad news of the day. If you don't know Daft Punk, I will just recommend maybe two songs, but really there are so many tracks that are extremely, extremely good. Maybe the first one, if you want to be happy and you want to have some energy, Get Lucky is an incredible song, but of course it's not in French, but still it's a French song in a way. Get Lucky was really great. And then the other one, Starboy, I think it's really nice. I think this one was done with the Weeknd, and I think it's a nice song too. But that's it. It's a bit sad. I know, mais c'est comme ça. Allez, let's start now. And let's start with the question of the day, if it's okay with you, of course. Que voulez-vous faire pour l'anniversaire de la chaîne? I've got no clue. I told you so far, no idea about what we could do for the anniversary of the channel. So if you've got some ideas, si vous avez des idées, write me one sentence. Tell me what we could do. Remember that it's on Saturday, so it's in 2 days. In 2 days, we'll have a special thing, but I've got no clue. Allez-y. Ice Cube's Get Lucky was not in French, but it was a song. It was a song done by Daft Punk, and Daft Punk is a French band. Allez, Omar nous rejoint, coucou. Georges Agot nous rejoint aussi, bonjour. Alors attention, attention, Olga qui dit Zoom. Well, Olga, c'est difficile, it's really tricky too. We've been trying to have this Zoom and YouTube at the same time. It's always challenging. It's only technical, the issue right now. We'll see. Well, thank you for offering this idea. Ice Cube's special day... In special exercise. D'accord. Well, so I need to come up with the exercise. Anne-Vie, bonjour, bonjour. Julia, je voudrais aller à la plage pour l'anniversaire, c'est possible. Vous pouvez y aller. Vous pouvez y aller, c'est la beauté de la chose. Julia, allez à la plage. Luciana, dans 2 jours pour l'anniversaire, peut-être que vous pourriez nous montrer les différents types de pâtisseries et vins. Ok. D'accord. Faisons de la pâtisserie ensemble. Fiona, nous mangeons du fromage et buvons du vin. Pourquoi pas? Pourquoi pas? Ça, c'est une bonne idée, Fiona. Ça, c'est une bonne idée. It's a good idea. I will bring my wine. I will have some cheese. And then we'll see for the rest. Yann Arte, comment faire l'année avant? Comment ça a fait l'année avant? Yann Arte, it's the first time. It's the first time because we've been starting these live sessions. Well, almost 1 year ago, because Julia told us it was in March, so it's the first time that we have the live sessions and that we can celebrate the birthday or the anniversary. Vous, Slat, j'aime beaucoup écouter Get Lucky. Bah oui, eh oui, elle est bien cette chanson. Sundar, spécial exercice, peut-être... you sing a French song for us. Alors Sundar, if I start to sing in French, then the climate will be terrible everywhere where you are. It will rain, it will snow, you will have some storms and maybe a tsunami. So you don't want that. Dark Tainer qui veut un quiz. Pourquoi pas? Bonne idée. Bonne idée. Omar, je veux te remercier. Bah oui, mais Omar, il faut proposer. Hein, proposer quelque chose. Bébé Mouette, boire du vin. C'est normal. Ça, c'est normal. Bébé Mouette, this is the normal thing that I can do during the live. I am usually having a glass of something. Renato, avez-vous déjà reçu de YouTube? Non. Qu'est-ce que je veux recevoir? I don't want anything from them. Roman, peut-être pouvons-nous essayer des différents jeux? Peut-être. Anne-Vie qui dit, how can I improve my French grammar? Well, by doing the exercises with us and by watching my videos. I mean, they're quite precise. Try to follow them in the order and then, you will really, really progress. And then you just do it with us, all the exercises. Right now, we're not doing the conjugation for a while, but we will go back to the conjugation. So this is something that we used to do. Vous, Slat, nous pouvons étudier une chanson peut-être. Oui, j'avais pensé à faire une dictée. I thought about doing some dictations based on the lyrics of certain songs. So it could be interesting. Denora, cuisiner un gâteau. Ah oui! But you can take the pictures. I mean, that was the idea. Annabelle, nous vous regardons cuisiner. Ma grande spécialité, le bœuf bourguignon. Oh. Mais bon, c'est y a énormément de calories. I need to stop to cook because, I mean, le bœuf bourguignon, it's like, it's really good, but, well, it's not really good for the... I mean, you need to run after. Olga, juste de la musique et parler. Oui, mais on parle pas. Ah, d'accord, d'accord. On parle comme ça. Fiona, je vais manger et boire avec vous. Oui. Cherilyn, live stream vous-même en train de préparer un gâteau. Selon les gens. Ah non! Cherilyn, you want me to. I can prepare a cake, but then people will tell me to put some terrible things. That's the way I was cooking with Yasmin when she was little. I was just like, you know what? You need to be creative. Put everything you want. And of course, we didn't eat anything after because it was too dangerous. Sophia X, je propose que nous écrivions quelques mots pour démontrer notre aperçu, c'est ça? Cherilyn, peut-être un changement de décor. Regardez, il y a là, j'ai changé, je commence à changer mon décor, j'adapte. Stardust, nous pouvons résoudre des énigmes françaises amusantes et passer un bon moment à la fin. Nous devrions boire une coupe de champagne. Chut. Ah ouais, champagne ou vin, c'est pas grave. Ou mousseux, comme vous voulez. Louis a qui dit, none of that disaster will happen, please sing in French. Well, trust me, Louisa. Trust me, Louisa. A tsunami will come right, you know, so I don't want that. Julia qui dit, je ne pense pas que la conjugaison me manque. Bah oui, mais bon. Victoria, faites une leçon sur Zoom. Well, the last one, it was a trauma. It was a real trauma, so I'm not fully sure if it's a good idea to do the Zoom thing. And you know, that was just the way it was. So we'll see. Gloria, vin et musique. Oui. Youssef, j'ai une idée pour l'anniversaire de la chaîne. Show us how to make a French sandwich. And a refreshing cold drink. Ah bah regardez, refreshing cold drink, c'est ici, beaucoup de glace et du liquide. Un gâteau est une bonne idée, Sundar peut-être un exercice sur Zoom, Omar nous pourrions envoyer un message audio, oui, envoyez des messages audio si vous voulez, Youssef faire un barbecue. Et Julia qui dit oui, les meubles sont revenus, des meubles différents, un petit concert, Ice Cubes, well it's good to dream, it is always good to dream, allez. Alors Victoria qui dit, I want to see my classmate friends, well that's the reason why we were supposed to meet, and we are supposed to meet in Paris, so we can see each other, and it could be fun, we could have some really great time. Allez, n'oubliez pas de cliquer, et on continue maintenant, so let's start the real thing, please find one word, on va chercher un mot qui commence avec la lettre L, but before starting, bébé Moette. Alors, Bébé Moette is sponsoring my coffee of the day. Merci beaucoup. Allez, so find me, please, one word that starts with L. Alors, Gloria is having a good idea. We can send each a picture of what represents a life where we live, if you want. So I will give you one more time the address. And then, of course, I mean, it would be really great that everyone could send a picture. After that, of course, it's always, well, a bit personal. So I don't really want to push anyone. Alors, and today it will be electronic, the music obviously, because Daft Punk just decided to stop being together. I'm so sad. Renato Silva, la lumière. Dark Tainer, une leçon. Anvi, un livre. Luciana, les lumières. Yann Arte, le verbe lire. Vouslat, une levure. Don't put any accent, you don't need to have the accent. Sophia X, lente. Fiona Adams, la lune. Sonic, ah, just decided to remove the thing, Sonic. Qu'est-ce qui se passe, Sonic? Denora, lentement. Olga Ruiz, la liberté, très bien. Julia qui dit lumineuse. Effectivement, lumineuse. So if it's the masculine, it would be lumineux, hein, with the X and not the SE. Y-Chan. Livre, un livre, Anvi, un lièvre, très bien, l'animal. Ensuite, alors attends, oh, Meshut Özil, you want to be rude, and that's not the concept in this life, so, I mean, don't be rude, just participate, it would be nice, but don't put some bad words, it's not really nice to be rude. Alors, Hilary des lèvres, yeah, you should put the S at the end, Hilary, because it's the plural form. Bébé mouette laissé, d'accord. Roman laissé, so in that case it's the infinitive. Fiona qui nous dit lundi, oui. Youssef qui nous dit lapin, un lapin. Annabelle, la lumière, assez bien. Sonic qui nous dit, ah, faites attention, l'icoris n'existe pas. Josh qui nous dit, organize the meeting in summer. Josh, it is the responsibility of Victoria Jacques. Victoria Jacques said, I will take care of the thing. So she will organize, I mean, the date and everything. But after that, of course, we'll have to meet. Anvi, un loup. Omar, lingue. Ah, une langue. Attention, Omar, remember, L-A-N-G-U-E. Stardust, longtemps. Cheryline, un laboratoire, bien sûr. Evelyne, livre. Ice Cubes qui nous dit, légal, local. Oh, Ice Cubes, only one. Julia, nous sommes féminins, d'accord. Luciana, les lumières. Vous aimez mes lumières? Elles sont sympathiques, ces lumières. Merci. Alors, Kai Hanna nous rejoint. Bonjour, bonjour, participez. Don't forget to click on the like. It would be really, really nice. And then now, please try to find me one word that starts with V. Allez-y. Alors, ça commence, Renato qui nous dit la vérité, ça c'est formidable. Darktainer, un vélo. Sundar qui nous dit la voiture. Anvi, un ventilateur. Yanarte, vivre. Fiona, Vincent. Non, non, non. Ah ben non, pas les prénoms, c'est trop facile. Vouslat, valoir. Benter, le ventre. Ice Cubes, vieux. Oui. C'est bon. Tanay qui nous dit l'heure. Rafraîchissez Tanay, vous êtes pas synchronisé. Annabelle, une victoire. Hilary, vendre. Sophia X, une victoire aussi. Julia, véritablement. Yanarte, un verre. Sophia X, un virus. Tanay, just one word, please, because after that it will last for hours. So the idea is just to find one word. Thank you. Stardust, voir. Roman, voir aussi. Alokaïsa, vendre. Omar, vinaigre. Anvi, virus masculin. Vinaigre, masculin aussi. Hein. Ensuite, Victoria, Jacques, vieillissant. It's not really uplifting, Victoria, Jacques. Qu'est-ce qui se passe? Cassandra, vraiment. Et Greg Chan, un vélo. Amélia, une ville, très bien, Amélia. Luciana, victoire, pardon, excusez-moi, Luciana. Youssef, voulait, d'accord, le verbe vouloir, au, à l'imparfait. Denora, une visualisation. Olga Ruiz, variété, une variété. Strange 73, vivre. Omordion, votre, très bien. Georges qui nous dit vivre aussi. Sabiha qui nous dit vendredi, très très bien. Hélène qui nous dit vous, est-ce que c'est voile? Si c'est voile, hein, Hélène c'est féminin, une voile. V-O-I-L-E, d'accord. Et Chériline, viscosimètre. Donc viscosimètre, c'est quoi? C'est un appareil qui va quantifier, mesurer la viscosité, j'imagine, ou qu'est-ce que c'est ? Allez, s'il vous plaît, un mot qui commence avec la lettre T. Et n'oubliez pas de cliquer sur like, merci beaucoup. Alors, ça commence. Anne-Louis qui est là. Donc, les toilettes, très bien. Fiona, le temps. Luciana, travailler. Julia, une trottinette. Attention, féminin. Dénora, un tableau. Très bien. Renato, le tailleur. Parfait. Rhoda, la tente. Une tente. Très bien. Darktainer, tendre, l'adjectif. Ou le verbe. Ça peut être aussi le verbe tendre. Sophia X, un tigre. Roman, tenir. Kay qui nous dit le temps, très bien. Strange 73, tout magnifique. Youssef qui nous dit un thé. Eh oui, ça c'est pas mal un thé. J'en ai bu hier et c'était assez agréable comme sensation. Benter, la température. Vous slat une tarte. Vous slat, la spécialiste de la tarte. À la pomme, c'est Ice Cubes et on le sait. Annabelle, temporairement, très bien écrit. Hillary, terrible. Ink Thinks, une tomate. Faites attention, c'est féminin, d'accord ? Une tomate. Tanné qui nous dit toujours. Evelyne qui nous dit un tableau. Cassandra, le théâtre. Yann Arte, la terre. Amélia, la terre aussi. Allo Kaïsa, têtu. Un petit peu comme moi. Victoria Jacques, tellement de vin, qu'est-ce que nous aurons ? Avec modération. Attention, moi j'ai expliqué, si je bois du vin, boum, comme ça. Après, il faut me porter. Les gens me portent. Je ne peux pas marcher. Y Chan, une tomate. Fatima, la tendresse. Omar, le terroir. Magnifique. Chériline, triphosphate. D'accord. Olga qui nous dit technique. Ensuite, Josh qui nous dit la tête. Sonic qui nous dit le théâtre. Sabina qui dit le toit. Sundar, la télé. Ice Cubes, la tragédie. Parce que je peux pas écrire plus d'un mot. C'est comme ça les règles. C'est les règles. Et Hélène qui nous dit la tente. Julia, est-ce que le tigre français peut rugir ? Je ne sais pas. On rentre dans les détails. Je ne sais pas. Je ne sais. Ça fait pas rire comme ça. Le tigre, ça doit faire rire, non ? N'oubliez pas de cliquer, s'il vous plaît. Allez, the numbers of the day. Remember, the numbers of the day, well, it's just a dictation with the numbers because it's beginner's level. In that case, I will pronounce them two times. The only exception will be the first one, obviously, because it's just with one digit. Donc, le premier, the first one, get ready. I will read it, so as I said, once, and you just need to write it after. On y va. 6 Alors, so far so good, hein, félicitations. So this one was a bit like an appetizer, hein, c'était un petit peu l'apéritif. So let's start now with numéro 2. So in that case, obviously, we'll have two digits, d'accord? I will read it twice. 92. 92. Write it. Habibi nous rejoint. Bonjour, bonjour, Habibi. Alors, oui, c'est très très bien, félicitations, hein. Bravo, 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 92, so in that case it will be 9 and 2, so 92 is 92, d'accord, so far, no, it was really good, nobody made a mistake, so really, really good, félicitations, là, c'est pas le digestif, là, non, c'est... C'est le digestif, c'est après. Attention, attention, three digits, and obviously I will read it twice, as I said. 473. 473. Write it, please. Alors, Renato, quelle est la différence entre chiffre et nombre ? Nombre, hein, on ne dit pas numéro. Numéro, c'est une autre chose encore. Chiffre et nombre. Chiffre, c'est digit. D'accord ? So, it means that it will be between 0 and 9. And after that, we call them numbers. So, numbers will include, by definition, at least two digits. Alors, be careful, because in that case, it was, be careful, Doc Tainer, you've been hearing 463, but in that case, it was 473, d'accord? Don't worry, it's a classic mistake. I can see that Roman did exactly the same mistake, which is, don't worry about that, hein? No stress. Yeah, okay, Roman, you've been correcting that after. Rhoda, she says, no idea, which it's okay, don't worry, Rhoda, it's not coming at the beginning, but after that it will come, don't worry about that. So the first one, 400, remember that 100 is 100, so 400, 400. After that, 73, 73, d'accord, so you combine the whole thing, 460, working. I've got one computer that is extremely strange now, let's see. Okay, I don't really know. I've got a computer that is behaving in a strange manner, so maybe we'll have a technical problem today. It's been a long time since we had one. Okay, numéro 4, four digits. So let's try to see how it goes. Four digits. Oupala, on y va. 4719. 4719. Allez-y. Alors, ok, apparemment ça continue, so apparently we're good now, ok, so Rhoda is saying that's easy, I don't get it Rhoda, you said no clue, now it's easy, d'accord, alors 4719, so 4000, 4000, 700, 700, 19, 19, 4, 7, 1 et 9, 4719. 19. Okay, let's have a look at numéro 5. Numéro 5, so obviously we'll have 5 digits in that case, and that will be the last one. 14780. 14780. Écrivez-le, s'il vous plaît. Alors, Mujahid is joining us. Bonjour, bonjour. Habibi says c'est très facile. But yeah, but it's beginner level, Habibi. You should join tomorrow and the day after. And of course, it's a bit more difficult. Alors, in that case, well, I'm looking at your things and it's extremely good. Hein? So, 14, 14, 000, 14, 780. Voilà, Riena Faire nous rejoint. Bonjour, bonjour. On a fini la dictée. We just finished the dictation. Anna, it's the same. Bonjour, bonjour. Allez, on continue. So don't forget to click on the like, hein, because you're 75 and there are only 60 likes, so you can do better. Alors, Kay, I need to study more. Don't worry, Kay. The numbers, it's always tricky. They've been achieving this level. I mean, the persons who are here, because they've been joining every day and I'm doing the dictation every day. So this is the only way you should do. Practice, practice, practice. And you will see after that, it will be a piece of cake. Allez, what is she thinking about? À quoi pense-t-elle? Write me a sentence, please. Alors, Yossi nous rejoint, il est en retard, mais non, Yossi, pas de problème, relaxez-vous. Nous avons fait uniquement une demi-heure. Et on va continuer, Yossi. Allez. Alors, c'est Rambo qui commence. Et Rambo nous dit, elle pense à l'amour. Mais elle n'est pas très joyeuse. she doesn't seem to be extremely happy about l'amour. I don't really know. Anvi, elle pense à son mari. D'accord. Luciana qui dit salut à Yossi. Très bien. Ah ben, je vous laisse le temps d'écrire. Hein. Julia qui dit elle pense mais où sont mes clés? Je dois rester à l'extérieur. Renato, un autre jour le soleil se couche. Omar, elle pense au week-end prochain. D'accord. Riena qui nous dit elle pense que son ami est de nouveau en retard. Fiona qui dit elle pense que ses belles plantes mourront l'hiver prochain. Stardust, elle se demande si elle doit couper l'arbre ou le déterrer pour Noël. Ah oui, c'est vrai, c'est un sapin. Un sapin intéressant quand même. Hein. Stardust, donc c'était ça, oui. Yesero, elle songe qu'elle doit faire bouger des choses car le temps lui échappe. Habibi, elle pense à son frère. Elle pense à son frère, peut-être. Ou à ton frère, mais ce serait bizarre, mon frère. Je n'en ai pas. Vouslat, elle pense à son petit ami. Darkteiner, elle pense pourquoi la vie est dure. Remember, Darkteiner, because V is feminine. So your adjective dur should be in the feminine form. D-U-R-E. D'accord. Roda. Ah, non, 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 Roda, you need to write in French. Hein? You need to write in French. This is the idea. Try, try, try. It's not really difficult. Go little by little. Try to make some short sentences and then little by little you can make longer and longer. Hilary, elle pense à son examen. Yossi, elle pense à son avenir. Sophia, elle pense qu'elle voudrait faire de l'huile avec des fleurs. Luciana, que faire de neuf pour la semaine prochaine? Eh oui. Denora qui dit « Je voudrais transporter cette plante ». L'emmener à la maison, peut-être. Yann Arthé, elle a perdu son ami. Ah ben ça, c'est terrible. Romane, elle pense comment cette plante a grandi si vite. Olga, il m'aime, il ne m'aime pas. Ça, c'est avec les fleurs. Elle le fait avec un arbre. Après, ça ne finit jamais. Annabelle, je pense que l'automne est là. Eh ben oui, Victoria Jacques, elle pense comment la beauté du printemps. Bébé Moette, elle est triste à propos de Daft Punk. Mais oui, tout le monde est triste à propos de... c'est terrible. Oh, moi, je vais écouter du Daft Punk en permanence maintenant et je vais pleurer. Pleurer comme une madeleine. Tanech, elle va manger toutes les plantes. Faire attention, hein, avec modération. Sonic, elle pense à quoi acheter au supermarché. Cheryline, elle recueille des preuves empiriques que les nombres de Fibonacci se produisent partout dans la nature. Habibi, vous avez déjà dit Habibi. Mujahid, elle pense à ce que je fais ici, c'est glacial. Ah, c'est frais, hein. On a l'impression que c'est frais. Ice Cubes, elle pense envoyer une photo du coucher de soleil et célébrer la chaîne de Vincent. Clic, clic, on a dit. Yulia, petit frère, c'est meilleur qu'une sœur aînée. Non, je crois pas, mais ça, c'est... Je ne pense pas, je ne pense pas. Moi, j'ai une sœur aînée. Hein. Marie Lucci qui dit « Je pense que tout sera ouvert ». Sundar qui discute avec Cheryline, merci beaucoup. Allez, so the next exercise, it's a classic for this level, and usually for the beginner or beginner intermediate, we try to have this, how would you translate exercise? So, in that case, well, look, how could you translate I watched a movie in French? Allez-y, write the sentence, and then we'll see exactly, I mean, we will compare it with my version, and of course, there are some possibilities to discuss and to negotiate. Alors, I'm looking at your form. So personally, I went for passé composé because it's extremely, it would be a bit rare to use the imparfait, but then it means that it should be in a description of something that happened in the past. So, j'ai regardé un film. It could be the first option. So, be careful, Rambo, you go for je vois un film. So, it would be possible, because in some cases you can hear people using voir un film. But the idea would be to stick to the concept of the past. So, let's put that in the past, like Renato Silva has been putting j'ai vu un film. So, clearly it would not be the first option, because normally it should be with regarder. But then, in some cases, people can use voir un film, d'accord? But then it should be really in the passé composé, j'ai vu un film. Non, don't go for the passé simple, Julia, c'est pas la peine. Numéro 2, numéro 2, I went grocery shopping. Allez-y. Alors, c'est Daddy Varenga. You're the first one. Yeah, be careful. So I've been adding this grocery because I really wanted to avoid shopping. Like Denora. They know how you went there. I didn't want you to go there. So the idea here is really to talk about the grocery shopping, so food and all the things that you will buy. Because in that case, the expression is faire les courses. This is really, really the expression that we use. And so obviously in that case, you need to put faire in the passé composé. Remember, faire is using avoir as a helping verb. So, j'ai, present for avoir. Then you put the past participle, fait, F-A-I-T. J'ai fait. And then you finish with the expression, les courses. J'ai fait les courses. So, Denora, je suis allé faire du shopping. It's slightly different because the shopping really in French, when you go for shopping, I've got this feeling that you are going to buy some clothes, for instance. So it's slightly different. Luciana, je suis allé à l'épicerie. Well, if you want, you should just drop your A from the article, l'épicerie. Dark Tainer, je suis allé au supermarché. But if you want, then you just need to put aller, the past participle. Remember, not the infinitive. Renato, je suis allé au supermarché, d'accord. So, I mean, these things, of course, we can accept them. Stardust, j'ai fait du shopping. Be careful, Stardust. Now, really, faire du shopping, it's like going to buy some things, clothes and things like that. It's not really buying food. Now, faire les courses, it's really the grocery shopping concept. So, je suis allé faire les courses. Oui, you can put the expression like that. J'ai fait un cours. Ah non, 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 Clétino. Non, 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 ça n'est pas possible. Très bien. Sukanya Rav, ou Ray, is joining us. Bonjour, bonjour. Allez, let's have a look at numéro 3. Numéro 3, regardez. I washed my clothes. How could you translate that into French? Allez-y. Alors, dans ce cas-là, so in that case, well, in fact, I just had the same as you, Sherilyn. Omar, same thing. So personally, I went for the verb laver, d'accord, that I've been putting in the passé composé tense. I'm looking at your things at the same time. Gloria, be careful, j'ai fait la vaisselle. It's when you wash the dishes. So it's slightly different in that case. So, j'ai lavé. Remember, Yossi, that you don't, it's not a reflexive verb. Je me suis lavé. It's when you wash yourself. This is really the concept of, you know, doing it on you, in fact. So in that situation, you just need to use laver. Remember, it will go with avoir as a helping verb. J'ai, present, lavé. Past participle with the accent, and then you just put mes vêtements. So yeah, in most of the cases, everybody went for vêtements. I could have accepted mes habits. Remember that habit is another possibility. You write it H-A-B-I-T-S. It would be possible too. Un habit. Marie-Lucie, mon pantalon, it's my trousers. So it's extremely specific in your case. So maybe not. Let's go for mes vêtements. I'm looking at the things because I can... J'ai fait la lessive, nous dit Yesero. Oui, pourquoi pas? Why not? It's the expression too, so it would be possible. In that case, Yesero, it means that you can wash everything too. So it could be also the bed sheets and everything. So it's slightly, it's a bit wider, I mean the expression, but why not? D'accord? Faire la lessive, Yesero, j'ai fait la lessive, hein? Oui, that's exactly what I said, Yesero. There is a bit, there is 20 seconds difference between what you write and what I see, d'accord, or what I say. Allez, on y va, numéro 4, regardez, I read a book. So same thing, I want to go in the past. Hein? I read a book. How could you say that in French? Alors, je regarde. Oui, d'accord. Hein, so, I guess everybody agrees on that. It's extremely difficult to find another solution in that case. So, the verb is lire. It's in the passé composé tense. So, lire uses avoir as a helping verb. So, avoir should be in the present. J'ai. So this is the first thing. Then remember that the past participle of lire is a tricky bird. Cui cui. It's a tricky one. You need to remember that it's extremely short and it's L-U, lu. So j'ai, lu will be your form, passé composé of lire. And after that, well, it's un livre, extremely difficult to change. You could go for un bouquin. We saw this one before. It's spoken. It's like you don't use that with everybody, but it would be another option. But then un livre is the normal way to use. My God, the other screen. There are some strange things happening here. Allez, on y va. Let's have a look at numéro 5. Numéro 5. I took the subway. And I would like that to be also, well, one more time in the past. Merci. Alors là, effectivement, hein, it's the same thing. It's extremely difficult to really have another option. So in that case, remember, so the verb should be prendre. Prendre should be in the passé composé form, so helping verb avoir. Past participle is pris, so you combine the two. J'ai pris, you have your passé composé. After that, it will be le métro. J'ai pris le métro. Be careful, because when you go for le train, in some cases you've been offering that, it's not really the same. Hein? Le train, it's really a train. And then le métro, it's really the subway. So we tend to make the difference between the two. If you use le train instead of le métro, people will be a bit confused. D'accord? So remember that subway is le métro, and then the train is le train. Allez, don't forget to click because you're 100. You are 100, and then you could please click because the idea is to try to achieve this limit of 100 likes. Merci beaucoup. Alors, remember that we spoke about that, and yes, it would be nice. It would be nice, maybe, if you want to share some pictures for the anniversary of the channel. It could be extremely great. I could make like a long, long lesson with all the pictures. So, if you want to send a picture for Saturday, so don't wait too long. You just take the picture, you write a little text. It could be anything, everything. It could be fun. And then you send it to vosphotos@fluent2plus.com. Vos photos without any space at fluent2plus.com. Send your pictures, send a little text with it, and then you just will have that. I will include them in the live, in the lesson, and we'll make some exercises with them. D'accord? Thank you very much. Allez, The Classic, the word of the day. Un mot pour résumer votre journée. So just one word to sum up your day. Remember, only one word. So it could be a verb, it can be a noun, it can be an adjective, it can be an adverb. Just one word, allez-y. I know that you like them, Fiona. You like my orchidées. Well, they're beautiful. Alors, on y va. Yesero, audacieux. Ça, c'est pas mal. Sonic, fatigante. Oh, c'est terrible. Omar, vacciné. You know, it's better than reaching the 100 likes. It's better than everything. Omar est vacciné. Bravo, Omar. Bravo. Fiona qui nous dit orchidée. Benter qui nous dit lente. Oui, c'est bizarre. Hein? Sometimes it's strange because it can last forever a day. Luciana, nuageux. Hélène qui dit bof. It happens. It just happened. It's okay. Don't worry about that. Tomorrow is another day. Denora qui nous dit... Qui nous dit... Alors, attendez. Yoga. Wow, ça, c'est bien. Habibi qui dit... oui. Alors, Habibi, qu'est-ce que vous dites? C'est vous, Slat, contente. Yulia, faim. Mm-hmm. Annabelle, joie. Ça, c'est sympathique. Gloria qui dit fantastique. Alors là, difficile à battre. Hein. It's really difficult to beat hein, this fantastic Gloria. It's been a while since my day was fantastic. Sundar, cauchemar. Ouais, ça arrive, ça arrive, ça arrive. Sakania, intéressante. Dark Tainer, attendez. Rihanna, gueule de bois. Alors, Rihanna, la technique, je ne sais pas la technique. Il y a beaucoup de techniques différentes, mais est-ce que ça marche? Mercurial Man, stressant. Ice Cubes, routine, eh bien oui. Parfois, c'est la routine. Hein. Sometimes it's just like that. Bébé Mouette, recommencer, ça c'est bien. Cassandra, se détendre, eh bien ça c'est formidable. Hillary qui dit travailler. Renato qui dit mon jour de congé, youpi! Bravo Renato. Yann Arte, la lumière. Rambo qui dit très content, ça c'est bien. Stardust, productif. Alors là, productivité, travail, c'est bien. Roda qui dit béni, ça c'est bien aussi. Roman qui dit attendre. Yossi qui dit fatigué. Bah alors, qu'est-ce qui se passe, Yossi? Edan qui dit paisible. Youssef qui dit oignon et tomate. C'est formidable. Oignon, moi j'adore l'oignon. L'oignon et la tomate, c'est incroyable, c'est délicieux. Je pourrais en manger tous les jours. Olga qui dit merveilleuse. Edgley qui dit fatiguée. Ah oui, c'est terrible. Chachi qui dit bonjour. Bonjour, bonjour Chachi, participez. Victoria qui nous dit curiosité. Merci beaucoup. Allez, if you arrived and then you didn't have the time to click on the like, please do it, s'il vous plaît, merci. Allez, it's the time for the dictation. So, if you are, if you've been doing, joining the lesson or the class before, you know that we'll have some sentences. I will read the sentences two times and then you will have the chance to write them. D'accord? So, let's go for it. Comment vous embrasser après des oignons? I don't kiss. I don't kiss anymore. It's over. I just kiss myself. And then my hands doesn't care if I smell onion or not. That's the way it goes. Allez, on y va. So I will read the sentences and then, if I can find them, obviously, and you have to write them. Let's start with the first one. Elle ne comprend pas quel est le problème. elle ne comprend pas quel est le problème. Write the sentence, please. Alors, je regarde. So I'm looking at your things. So the first thing that was maybe a bit difficult, it was the verb. So the verb is comprendre. So remember that comprendre belongs to the third group. So when you will have to conjugate it for the third person, like we have here, elle, d'accord, the singular, you will have to write it C-O-M-P-R-E-N-D, d'accord? So in that case, this is the first thing. After that, quel est, so quel, this is the tricky thing, because you need to remember that quel, you will define the gender according to le problème. Le problème, you can see that it's masculine, so it means that quel will have to be in the masculine form Q-U-E-L. So you don't put the feminine. The feminine would be Q-U-E-L-L-E. You don't, because le problème is masculine. D'accord? So you stick to the masculine form. Quel, Q-U-E-L. Elle ne comprend pas. So it's the negative form. Quel est le problème. If you've got the accent on your keyboard, remember that problème goes with an accent grave on the first E. D'accord? Problème. You really pronounce it. It's really open. Problème. Allez, let's have a look at numéro 2. Numéro 2, on y va. One second, I just need to scroll. Voilà. Elle voyage quand elle veut. Elle voyage quand elle veut. Write the sentence. Ouais, d'accord, so it's quite good, in fact. This one is not tricky, at least I wanted to make some quite short sentences for this level. So the first thing is the verb is voyager. Voyager, remember, it ends with er, the infinitive, so it belongs to the first group. It's not really tricky, especially, I mean, at this person, we'll see that, you know, it can be tricky for the new form, but it's another thing. I need to click on Julia because I don't know why you're blocked with your little icons. Alors, elle voyage. So remember, you will have to conjugate it. Third person of the singular, the ending will be E. Elle voyage. V-O-Y-A-G-E. And then after that, quand? In most of the cases, from what I saw, I mean, you write it really, really well. So, quand, Q-U-A-N-D. D'accord? So, donc, ça, c'est clair. And after that, the other thing is the verb vouloir. So, the verb vouloir, it's a tricky one because it belongs to the third group. And remember that when you will conjugate it in the singular form, so, je veux, V-E-U-X, final X not pronounced. Tu veux, same form. V-E-U-X, final X not pronounced. Il, elle veut, like we have here. V-E-U-T, final T not pronounced. So in fact, it will be exactly the same phonetical form. Je veux, tu veux, il veut, elle veut. D'accord? But you need to remember that it will be with X in the end for je, X in the end for tu, T in the end for il, elle, and then on. Elle voyage quand elle veut. Allez, numéro 3. Numéro 3, nous continuons. Nous continuons. Elle ne dit pas souvent la vérité. Elle ne dit pas souvent la vérité. Allez-y. Alors oui, effectivement, hein, so it's really good. Remember that the verb, so once again, and the verb is dire, third group, a bit tricky, but then when it goes for the three first person, so it will be je dis, D-I-S, S not pronounced. Tu dis, same form, D-I-S, S not pronounced. Il, elle, dit, D-I-T. T not pronounced. So one more time, and the three first persons will be pronounced exactly the same way. Je dis, tu dis, il dit. So this is really something that I want to point out because many persons say that, oh yeah, it's so tricky, etc. But then if you think about that, we've got so many forms that we pronounce the same way. So it means that, in fact, speaking in French might seem more difficult than writing in French, but it's the opposite. Writing properly is extremely challenging, but I mean, these forms, they are not really tricky. So in that situation, it's elle ne dit pas. So this is the negative form. Of course, I wanted to squeeze a little adverb. So souvent, remember that souvent, and you write it quite well, E-N-T in the end, S-O-U, V-E-N-T, souvent, d'accord? And the last thing, la vérité. If you've got the accent on your keyboard, remember that the two from this word will have this accent aigu. Elle ne dit pas souvent la vérité. Numéro 4. Allez, numéro 4, well, it continues, so it will be a short one. Elle ne pense qu'à elle. Elle ne pense qu'à elle. Write the sentence, please. And yes, it's true. If you didn't have yet the time to click on the like button, it's now or never. Well, maybe not, but... Well, if you don't do it, I will cry. I will cry right away, so be careful. Be careful. Click on the little thing. Merci beaucoup. Alors, regardons. I'm looking at the things that you're writing. In fact, it's extremely, extremely good. So, in that sentence, so we have what we call the la restriction. So, when you want to, the restriction would be another possibility to say it. It's the ne que structure. So, this only concept, in fact, in French, we will put ne first, and then you put the verb as usual, and you close it with que. So, verb, penser, regular verb, not really tricky. Third person of the singular, one more time, because I wanted to do everything in the L form. So, pense, P-E-N-S-E, d'accord? Elle ne pense que. So, this is the thing now. And after that, I need to put the preposition à, and after that, elle. The pronoun. Because we have que, as usual, and another vowel after, your e from que will have to disappear, and then you will put the apostrophe. Elle ne pense qu'à elle. Elle ne pense qu'à elle. Allez, let's finish with this numéro 5. Numéro 5, same thing. I will read the sentence two times and you will write it. Elle est partie quand il faisait froid. Elle est partie quand il faisait froid. Write the sentence. Alors, regardons ensemble. So let's have a look. First thing that we need to really, take into consideration is the verb. The verb is partir. Partir, remember that when you will put it in the passé composé form, then you will have to use as a helping verb être. D'accord? This is really important because this is one of the rare verbs that will be constructed with être. So you just need to remember that. So, elle est. Être should be in the present. After that, you will put your past participle, parti. The past participle is P-A-R-T-I. But, so the basic form, hein? But because we are using être, remember that the rule is quite strict. When you use être for all the compound tenses, le passé composé is one of them, you have to mark at the end of your past participle, whether the feminine, or then the plural, or then the feminine plural. In that case, elle is feminine singular. So what does it mean? It means that in the end of partie, you will have to put the mark of the feminine, not the plural because it's the singular. So the mark of the feminine will be a. So you have your past participle, P-A-R-T-I, basic form, plus the feminine form, E, in the end. You will pronounce it exactly the same way, and I know that's just the way it is, but still you need to write it if you want to write it properly. And the other thing that was a bit tricky was this faire, and I wanted to put faire in the imparfait form. It was cold, because it's not something that happens like for a few minutes or few hours. It was something that lasts a bit longer. So, faisait, F-A-I-S-A-I-T. Elle est partie quand il faisait froid. This is the way it will go. Mohamed Dikones nous rejoint. Bonjour, bonjour. Don't forget to click on the like. S'il vous plaît, s'il vous plaît. This is the only thing I ask you, of course, to do the exercises, but to click on the like first. Merci beaucoup. Allez, on y va. Allez, what does she say? He say, sorry. Just imagine, que dit-il? Que dit-il cet homme? I think that the picture is so great. Que dit-il? Alors, Rotten Tomatoes is joining us. Bonjour, bonjour. You can participate. It will be a pleasure. Don't forget Rotten Tomatoes to click on the like. Merci beaucoup. Alors, Aslam Ikram, qu'est-ce qu'il dit? Well, that's the question. Luciana, que faire pour le dîner? C'est possible. Peut-être que c'est la question. Maybe that's the question that he's asking himself. Hein. Qu'est-ce qu'il dit? Alors, Dark Tainer, la vie est dure, mais vivre les jours avec, attention Dark Tainer, sourire is a masculine word, so un sourire, but it was really a good sentence. Vuslat, il dit qu'il trouve cet oiseau magnifique, eh oui. Rambo, il est presque minuit au Laos, maybe you should go and sleep. Denora, sois libre. This is a nice one. De Yesero, il dit à son oiseau, maintenant tu voles car tu pèses trop et je suis fatigué. I really like the things that Yesero is writing. And it's true. Hein? It must be really heavy, Yesero. Hein? Just imagine carrying the guy. Because he wants to stay. I mean, the bird doesn't want to move. Yulia, le ciel est gris. L'oiseau ne veut pas voler. Et ça, c'est dommage. Annabelle, je me sens bien ce matin et si frais. Annabelle, elle est très optimiste. Omar, il dit qu'il y a encore beaucoup de temps pour y arriver. Ça, c'est possible aussi. Renato, si tu t'en vas, je vais tomber. C'est possible aussi. Non, c'est comme ça, c'est vers l'avant. Hein. Sundar, ok, discute avec Cherylyn. Hillary, c'est une autre journée de travail. Oui, c'est vrai. Roman, mon ami et moi sommes allés marcher aujourd'hui. Qu'en est-il de vous? Olga qui dit, je voudrais voler. Qui? L'oiseau ou l'homme? On ne sait pas. Fiona, il dit qu'il travaille toute la journée, mais c'est la paix et l'harmonie. Eh ouais. Yann Arte, il dit, allez! Il faut voler maintenant. Il faut voler comme un grand. Ice Cubes, il dit, qu'est-ce que tu as fait des mignons familles dans ta chambre, Vincent? Les mignons? Ah! Alors, Ice Cubes, c'est un secret. Regardez là. Vous voyez la guitare? Sous la guitare, là. Ah, pardon, c'est là. Regardez, il y en a deux. Mais les autres sont grands, donc ils sont là. Les autres, vous ne les voyez pas. Hein? You cannot see them, but they're really here. All the family is here. Don't worry, the whole family is here. And I even have like 100 Legos of Nicolas next to... You cannot see them, but really, I've got like a bunch of Legos here. Alors, on continue. Est-ce que c'était... Voilà. Cassandra, il dit à son oiseau de le laisser aller pour les vacances. Sundar, la vie est une joie quand tu es proche des autres animaux. Et oui, Yossi, moi et mon oiseau, nous sommes un spectacle. Et ça, c'est possible. Victoria, il pense, j'espère que c'est une bonne image. Ah, vous croyez qu'il pose? Il pose comme ça. Est-ce que c'est joli? C'est possible. Sophia X, il dit que l'oiseau est le meilleur ami car il revient toujours chez lui. C'est possible aussi. Cherylyn, pourquoi est-ce que j'agis comme un point d'appui pour l'oiseau qui joue à la bascule? C'est possible. On ne sait pas. Mohamed, il dit qu'il prend sentir à qu'il veut sentir l'oiseau. Ensuite, Stardust, il pense « Quelle belle compagnie sur mon chemin !» Alors ça, c'est formidable, merci. Il manque un clic, un seul clic, la personne qui clique maintenant, eh bien, nous fait passer le cap des 100 clics, des 100 likes. Allez-y, s'il vous plaît, soyez généreux. Allez, how would you translate? Alors, Goafeld, yeah, Goafeld, venez dans le cours demain. Come tomorrow in the lesson, because tomorrow it will be in French, okay? And the day after it's in French. So basically, it's if you've got a question, just come, because today it's like in English and in French. So I don't really want to spend too much time on that, but we could discuss about that, no problem at all. How would you translate? How would you translate? Well, I mean, you know the exercise. It's a classic one. So look at that. So you will see that it will be quite funny. I hope it will be funny. How could you translate troubled? Troubled, how could you translate that? So write that, please. We just want one more. I can see that it's only 99 likes and I want one more, please. S'il vous plaît, un like de plus. Oui! C'est formidable, je suis un homme heureux. Alors, on est d'accord, we agree that the translation, in fact, it's extremely, extremely simple because it's coming from the same thing and it's trouble. So troubled will be troublé. As you can see, troublé. Well, as usual in French, we've got the masculine and the feminine form. You will add this in the end for the feminine, but still you don't pronounce it. So phonetically, it will be the same. Troublé, masculine. Troublé, feminine. And now this is the funny thing. I think it was Julia. Julia was offering this type of exercise, and because I'm listening to you, well, could you please find on your keyboard, on your computer, the emoji that, I mean, relates to this troubled emotion. Allez-y, s'il vous plaît. It's really interesting to see. You can see that it's not universal. It is not universal at all. This is my whole point. People are sending themselves out to each other some emoji, but people have no clue. I mean, because if I receive these things, I don't know that you're troubled. I mean, it's not really clear. I like the one from Denora. The one from Denora is really great. It's a cat, no? The little cat in the box. This is really, really nice. Allez, let's continue. Numéro 2. Numéro 2. How could you translate this embarrassed word? Alors, je regarde. Oui, c'est très, très bien. So, same thing here. I mean, we're talking about an adjective in that case. So, embarrassé, you've got the masculine form. And as you can see, the feminine form, as usual, you will have to add this final that won't be pronounced. So, embarrassé, masculine form. embarrassé feminine form will be pronounced exactly the same way, but then you will write it slightly differently. Let's have some fun now. Give me the emoji that matches this embarrassé concept. Allez-y. I like the one from Ice Cube because you don't see anything, just the two eyes like that. It's really nice. Yes, oh, it's interesting. Somebody sweating and then just became orange. Stardust, it's interesting too. So let me look at the others. Olga, you've got an interesting one. It's an ape, c'est un singe. Hilary. Mais qu'est-ce que c'est? You've got some really interesting emoji. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that when you send the things, I mean, people, they don't really get it. Dark Tainer, you put an ape. C'est un singe? Un whistiki, peut-être? Je ne sais pas. Let's have a look at numéro 3. Numéro 3, on y va, on y va. How could you say asleep in French? Alors, oui. D'accord, Omar, I agree with you. It's quite good. Fiona Adams, too. Ice Cubes, no problem. Be careful. Yeah, I'm looking for the adjective, in fact, in that case. Hein. Alors, dormant, dormante, Julia, with the A-N, A-N-T would be an option, but it would not really be the first one that I would find. Endormi would be the best option. So, in that situation, it's the same thing, hein? Adjective, so it means that the masculine form will be ending with E. Feminine form, you will add the mark of the feminine, so E. Endormi, masculine, endormi, feminine, you pronounce them exactly the same way. Endormi, endormi. And one more time, because this is the idea of the exercise, could you find me the emoji that, expressed this endormi concept? Allez-y. Alors, it's interesting because Fiona, you've been putting the cat. So the cat in the box, he's sleeping, maybe. After that, you've got the other one, the sleepy one. D'accord, très bien. Ice Cubes, you've been putting... Well, first, I agree, but then the two others, I mean, they're... Like they're yawning or they're crying, I'm not really sure. C'est pas clair. Dark Tainer, ah oui, you've got the bed too. Hein? Oh là là, Hilary, you've got... Qu'est-ce qui se passe? Le personnage comme ça qui dort, peut-être, je ne sais pas. Victoria Jacques, ok. Omar, ah, so you're putting with the cross, c'est très intéressant. Sophia, non! Ah oui, d'accord. Sophia, it's endormi, but it's like forever in that case. And we're talking about the zombie now. Hein? Eh oui, c'est possible. Allez, numéro 4. Numéro 4, nous regardons ensemble. And it's a wink. Like that. How could you say that in French? Allez-y. Allez, Sundar va se coucher. Sundar is going to bed. Sweet dream, Sundar. Bonne nuit et à demain, si vous le voulez. Alors, un clin d'œil, hein, this is quite good, un clin d'œil, it's a wink, and obviously, you know that I am expecting the emoji. Remember that I wanted to give you the expression, because the expression, it's faire un clin d'œil, hein. Faire un clin d'œil, it's really like that. So this is faire un clin d'œil. So we use faire, and in fact we use a lot faire, you know, for many, many expressions in French. So faire un clin d'œil, could you please find that on your keyboard? Allez-y. I like, there are several versions. You've got just the wink, hein, le clin d'œil, but Amelia, she found the clin d'œil, and then with the tongue. Hilary, you putting the ghost. Non, qu'est-ce qui se passe? Oh, Julia, elle met l'œil. This is scary, hein? Ça fait très très peur. Allez, the last one, numéro 5, joyful. Joyful, how could you translate joyful into French? Allez-y. Alors oui, Yessero qui nous dit être plein de joie. Why not? But then maybe we should stick to the adjective, I mean the concept of the adjective, and in that case, so the masculine form would be joyeux, so as you can see you end with E-U-X. Feminine form in that case will be joyeuse, E-U-S-E. Joyeux, masculine form, joyeuse, feminine form. So it's, in fact, I mean, as you can see, it's coming from the same family. And look, could you give me, please, it will be the last one for the emoji, but the emoji that could transcribe, that would express this joyeux, joyeuse concept. Allez-y. Ah, so Stardust, she's going for the dancer again. It reminds me when we had the discussion about the dancer. The lady who is dancing. Hilary, she goes for the pouf. C'est la fête d'Etso. Ah ben oui, Eva, très bien. Roman, oh, you've got the smile with the teeth. You've got everything. Annabelle, avec les étoiles dans les yeux, with the stars in the eyes. Fiona, wow, you've got a lot. Yesero, ah oui, avec effectivement le trèfle. Sophia X, you go for this one. Ice cubes. Like that, like that, like that, like that. Non, c'est pas clair. C'est pas clair, Ice Cube. It's not clear at all. You send me that, I understand. That, I'm not sure. That, I'm not sure. Non, I mean that. Non, you didn't have this one. D'accord. Allez, it's the best place. Remember this one. C'est le meilleur endroit pour. Write me a sentence. It's the best place for. Just imagine the rest. Alors, Denora qui... c'est le meilleur endroit pour la torture. Gloria, c'est le meilleur endroit pour l'interrogation. Sonic, c'est le meilleur endroit pour être torturé. Should put the accent, maybe. I mean, if you have the... No, you don't have the accent, so it's okay. Hillary, c'est le meilleur endroit pour étudier. Pour se concentrer, hein. You can, yeah, you don't have a lot of distraction in that case. Julia, c'est le meilleur endroit pour torturer quelqu'un, très tranquillement. Yesseron, c'est le meilleur endroit pour être piégé par un tueur en série. C'est vrai. Yossi, c'est le meilleur endroit pour être embarrassé, c'est vrai. Fiona, c'est le meilleur endroit pour tourner un film d'horreur. Ice Cube, c'est le meilleur endroit pour tuer quelqu'un. Oups, c'est parti. Dark Tainer, c'est le meilleur endroit pour... Alors, lire un livre, ou si vous voulez, peut-être. Annabelle, c'est le meilleur endroit pour une séance de photos. Oui, pourquoi pas. Roman, c'est le meilleur endroit pour kidnapper quelqu'un de riche. Brainwash, c'est le meilleur endroit pour mourir de la peur. C'est vrai. I knew it would be interesting. When I selected this picture, I knew it would be extremely funny and interesting. Olga, c'est le meilleur endroit pour Louvre des théâtres. Comment ça, des théâtres? Ah, vous pensez pour une pièce de théâtre, Olga. Stardust, c'est le meilleur endroit pour me rappeler sur le film Reservoir Dogs. Oh, oui. Ah oui, je l'ai vu une fois. I just saw it once, I didn't want to. Ah oui, oui, oui. It's just like, c'est arrivé près de chez vous. Oh, I mean, these are movies that I don't want to watch them a second time. Victoria Jacques, I'm looking at you. C'est le meilleur endroit pour être effrayé. Et ça, c'est vrai. C'est vrai, c'est vrai. Vous, Slat, c'est le meilleur endroit pour avoir peur. Oui. Benter, c'est le meilleur endroit... pour questionner un terroriste. Yann Arte, c'est le meilleur endroit pour le théâtre. Soukania, c'est le meilleur endroit pour une pièce. Cherilyn, faire croire à quelqu'un que sa vision des couleurs est gravement altérée. C'est vrai, hein? Mais il y a beaucoup de couleurs, voyons. Amélia, c'est le meilleur endroit pour une interrogation. Aidan, c'est le meilleur endroit pour être sous. Ah, because you're not bumping in anything. On ne se cogne pas dans des choses. Cassandra, c'est le meilleur endroit pour kidnapper quelqu'un, l'enfermer. Et je vois ça dans un film d'action. Merci beaucoup, Cassandra. Allez, regardons. So we'll have the, well, translation of the sentences now. We'll continue. I mean, this is the concept during this level. Numéro 1, we are going out. So this series will be with the we thing. So let's stick to the nous, if that's okay with you. We can use the on, but it's not as simple. I mean, it's not as complicated to conjugate and to structure. So I would like you to use the new form for each of the sentences. S'il vous plaît, it's just an exercise. Allez-y. Alors, we've got several options. So the first one would be obviously to use the present, because we're talking about something that is right now happening. So we should use maybe the present in the first position. So nous sortons. Then Amelia is offering the futur proche. Nous allons sortir. And it's totally correct. Olga Ruiz, go for the same. And it's good. Gloria too. Third option, Denora is going for the future, the real future, so future simple. Nous sortirons. Why not? Why not? Of course, it depends on the context, because first, I would really like to keep it close to the present, because this is something that is happening right now or that is about to happen. So if you go with this future simple, I've got the feeling that somehow it gets farther from me, it's in the future, d'accord? So I could agree, but in certain situations. Second one, we do not want to answer. How could you translate that into French? Alors, je regarde, oui, hein, so the verb should be vouloir, in that case, you put the negative form, so nous ne voulons pas, and then the other one will be répondre, répondre should be definitely in the infinitive form, because it's coming right after, vouloir, that is conjugated. Nous ne voulons pas répondre, d'accord, so this one is actually quite clear for almost everybody, so it's good, we can continue with the number 3, numéro 3. Look, we don't like this story. Allez, Darktainer is leaving us. Au revoir, Darktainer, and see you soon. Alors, remember that in that case, well, we should use the verb aimer. We should conjugate it for the nous form. So, nous aimons. But then now we will put the negative form. Nous n'aimons pas. D'accord, nous n'aimons pas. And after that, remember that histoire is feminine, so it means that the demonstrative that you will use, cette, should be in the feminine form, and the feminine form will be C-E-T-T-E. Cette histoire, d'accord. Anna Alborès is joining us. Remember, Anna, the idea of this exercise, of course, you can use on, but on is extremely simple. So the idea is really to work on the nous, d'accord. When you talk, you can use on, it's not a problem. The idea is really to work on the nous form just to see how you conjugate it, d'accord. This is the reason why we all put the nous form. And we know that when we talk, if it's not formal, we could go for the on form. Allez, numéro 4, we prepared breakfast. How could you say that in French? Alors, ici, ouais, the idea is to use the past tense, hein, so in that case, obviously, we would go for the passé composé. So, passé composé of, préparé, it's actually quite simple. You first use as the helping verb avoir, as we usually do. So, nous avons. After that, you will put your préparé, remember, past participle. So, it will be with a accent aigu in the end. Nous avons préparé, and then le petit déjeuner. So this is the breakfast. Le petit déjeuner. I'm looking at your forms at the same time. Everything seems to be quite good. So nous avons préparé le petit déjeuner. Numéro 5. We came at noon. As you can see, it's always in the past. We came at noon. Alors, let's have a look because you're offering several options. So my option would be to use really the verb venir. Venir, it's to come. But then obviously we can have sometimes some other things. Sonic is going for nous sommes arrivés. Same thing, it could be possible, but it depends on the context. It would not be, let's agree on that, the first one. But then, of course, in some situations, it could be totally acceptable, like Gloria. Gloria went for nous sommes arrivés. Well, it depends. It depends on the situation. It's not the first one. Huh? The first one should be venir, because venir is to come. And so if you say we came, it would be nous sommes arrivés. Remember that venir is using être as a helping verb. So nous sommes in the present tense. Venu. Remember that because we're using être as a helping verb, we have to put the plural form at the end of venu. In that case, well, it would be possible, of course, to have also a group of ladies, a group of women. And in that case, it should be the feminine plural. So it means that as an option, it would be ES, d'accord? Phonetically, it's exactly the same. But still, if you really want to be, purist, you should put the gender. If you're talking about a group of women, then it should be written V-E-N-U-E-S, d'accord? Allez, nous sommes venus à midi. Hilary is leaving us. Well, it's soon the end of the lesson. But then see you when we see. Au revoir. Allez, let's have a little exercise of vocabulary. First one, how could you, what is it? What is it? We're talking about the emojis again, but now we're not talking about the emotions. We're just talking about the vocabulary. What is it? I mean, write me the word with the article, obviously. Alors oui, effectivement, c'est un téléphone. Hein, c'est un téléphone. So you put the two accents on the first two so accent aigu. Un téléphone. C'est un téléphone. Alors, I wanted to introduce, in fact, this expression. Ça sert à. So you use it for. So the verb is servir and the expression is ça sert à, and after that you will put the verb as you can see in the infinitive. So look, un téléphone, ça sert à appeler des gens. So it is used to call persons. D'accord? So remember the structure, ça sert à. Because we will use that for the next exercise, not exercises, but parts of the exercise. D'accord? Look at that. Numéro 2. Numéro 2. So what is this thing in French? Allez-y. Alors, in that case, we've got two options. The first one would be an ordinateur or an ordinateur portable, or then un portable. Be careful, because in most of the cases, French people, when they use un portable, somebody is sending me a message, un portable is usually for the phone. So, but in some cases, I mean, it can be quite clear if you show your thing, then they will understand that you're talking about your computer. Un ordinateur portable, un ordinateur importable. And so my question now, to reuse the structure that I gave you previously, the question is, un ordinateur, ça sert à quoi? So I would like you to answer and reuse this structure, ça sert à, remember that it should be with an infinitive verb, d'accord? Allez-y. Je regarde, je vois que... Donc, brainwash, qui dit un ordinateur, ça sert à jouer. Chez Julia, qui dit un ordinateur, ça sert à moi. Non, you need to put a verb. Akanksha qui nous dit, ça sert à étudier. Yesero, ça sert à apprendre sur tant de sujets. Yossi, ça sert à... No, Yossi, the idea is to use the structure, ça sert à... and then the verb. It's really, really systematic, this exercise. Cassandra, ça sert à travailler. Chez Denora, ça sert à travailler. Cheryline, ça sert à remplacer les humains. Just like in all these movies, these science fiction movies, like, oh yes, they've been replacing us. It will come. Sukana, ça sert à surfer sur Internet. Benter, ça sert à apprendre. Anna qui nous dit au revoir Anna, see you tomorrow at the same time or then the days after, not on Sunday, this is the only day when I don't do the live. Akanksha, ça sert à étudier. Omar, ça sert à faire des documents et surfer sur Internet. Roman, ça sert à tout. You went for that, ok. Yossi, ça sert à toutes les choses possibles, ok. He's flexible, monsieur Yossi. Vous vous adaptez, c'est une qualité. Hernele, ça sert à travailler. Put the infinitive. Hein. Vous, Slat, un ordinateur, ça sert à travailler. Gloria, ça sert à discuter à vidéo, si vous voulez. Vidéo chatée. Fiona, un ordinateur, ça sert à trouver les informations sur Internet. Amélia, ça sert à apprendre les langues à YouTube. Luciana, ça sert à communiquer et participer aux leçons avec Vincent. Oh, ça c'est très très gentil. Mercurialman, alors attention, hein, Mercurialman, faites attention, ça sert à quelque chose. Olga, ça sert à étudier. Sophia, ça sert à surfer. Annabelle Nouvelle, ça sert à acheter en ligne. Alors là, Annabelle, est-ce que vous êtes clic, clic, clic et vous achetez beaucoup de vêtements, peut-être des chaussures. Peut-être des chaussures. On ne sait pas. Roman qui nous dit ça sert à écrire. Merci. Le numéro 3, qu'est-ce que c'est? Qu'est-ce que c'est, s'il vous plaît? Donnez-moi le mot. Alors oui, je vois que ça arrive, ça commence à arriver, donc effectivement, hein, c'est une imprimante, et bien sûr, ma question, c'est une imprimante, ça sert à quoi? La même structure, hein, so the same structure that we had previously, ça sert à, and then you put a verb, hein, it's a systematic exercise, the idea is to catch the structure. Alors voilà, hein. So you got the idea, is obviously that we are going from imprimant to the verb, and the verb is a regular verb from the first group, and it's imprimé. So you can say that, of course, I mean, ça sert à imprimer des papiers, ça sert à imprimer. Alors, Sukaina, when false, ça sert à copier, if you want. But then the idea is, was to use this imprimer. Be careful, Cassandra, I'd déprimer, it's to depress. It's not the same. It looks the same, but that imprimer, it's to print. Déprimer, it's when you have une déprime, depression. So be careful, it's not really the same. But then they look really the same. Allez, numéro 4. Numéro 4, qu'est-ce que c'est? Oui, effectivement, Yesero est en forme. Hein. C'est un clavier. Yesero is the first one. Bravo, Yesero, the others too. So remember that, as in English, it's a keyboard, so you can use it for other things. I mean, if you're talking, for instance, about the musical instrument, you can say un clavier tout. Hein, but in that case, obviously, it's connected to, well, the computer. Un clavier, ça sert à quoi? Alors, Omar qui dit ça sert à envoyer l'information à l'ordinateur. Eh oui, effectivement. Alors, Roman, ça sert à taper ou à écrire. Eh oui, Denora, ça sert à taper. Stardust, ça sert à taper. Est-ce qu'il y a d'autres personnes qui vont écrire des choses? Yulia, ça sert à taper l'information. Très bien. Sukena qui nous dit ça sert à écrire. Amelia Pond qui dit un clavier, ça sert à écrire. Be careful, you need to write the écrire. Hein. Écrivez doesn't exist. Akanksha, ça sert à écrire quelque chose sur l'ordinateur. Très bien. Allez, numéro 5, and we'll finish with this one. Qu'est-ce que c'est? Mais qu'est-ce que c'est? Alors oui, c'est une télévision, c'est une télé, voilà, pas de problème. Alors certaines personnes pensent que c'est un moniteur, in some cases you want to put a monitor, Julia, un aquarium. Mais non, c'est pas un aquarium. Allez, une télévision, ça sert à quoi? Alors, if you arrived and you didn't have the time yet to click on the like, do it. Do it. Let's try to see how many likes we can have for this lesson. It would be really nice if we could have, I mean, more than 100, because basically we've been reaching this point already. Alors, Brainwash qui nous dit ça sert à casser son écran. Pourquoi pas, Yesero, ça sert à regarder des séries intéressantes. Denora, ça sert à s'échapper. Amelia, ça sert à regarder des films. Romante, ça sert à regarder des films ou des programmes. Yossi, ça sert à perdre beaucoup de temps. Annabelle, ça sert à regarder des films. Vouslat, ça sert à regarder des films aussi. Stardust, ça sert à regarder des films ou du football. Ho, ho, ho. Fiona, ça sert à regarder des nouvelles, les actualités. Omar, ça sert à regarder des séries, des films et la chaîne de Vincent avec Chromecast. En fait, attention, il y a des délais. Le délai. Allez, merci beaucoup. Allez, let's not forget that in 2 days we've got, well, the anniversary of the channel. So if you want to send your pictures, it would be really nice. I could make a lesson based on your pictures, and it could be extremely, extremely nice. And don't forget that today it was a terrible day because le groupe Daft Punk s'est séparé. I am so, so sad, but still, this is the way it goes. Merci beaucoup. Au revoir et à demain. So see you tomorrow. Au revoir.